Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A meteorite that crashed to Earth half a century ago has provided a jolt of surprise to astronomical theory. The object, called the Allende Meteorite, exploded over the desert in Mexico in 1969. Scientists studying meteorite fragments have made a shocking discovery. Material in the fragments, which the scientists have interpreted as, quote, pre-solar grains, or interstellar stardust composed of silicon carbide, is now being described as the oldest known material on Earth. Of course, this does not fit with the notion that meteorites, as well as comets and asteroids, formed 4.5 billion years ago, as the leftovers of the early solar system. One of the scientists studying the material said of the finding, "What is surprising is the fact that pre-solar grains are present. Following our current understanding of solar system formation, pre-solar grains could not survive in the environment where these inclusions are formed." Those who have followed this series are well aware that it has now been routine for many years for comets, asteroids, as well as meteorites on Earth to completely defy the standard story of our solar system's formation and evolution. When it comes to meteorites on our own planet, another major shock to the system came in 2016, when a team of scientists reported the findings of their chemical analysis of a meteorite called Gujiba. What the investigators found was that the meteorite's geological origins were much too complex for any conventional theory to explain. The team concluded that the meteorite formed from the molten debris of a planetary collision in the asteroid belt. A phys.org report on the research states, "Based on chemical traces preserved in Gujiba, the target planet might have been even larger than the asteroid Vesta, one of the largest bodies in the asteroid belt with a diameter of about 326 miles. A lead investigator said of the discovery, "People used to say that meteorites like Gujiba were the building blocks of the solar system. Now, we know it's the construction debris of the planets." When it comes to mysterious meteorites on Earth, perhaps none has confounded conventional theory more than the so-called Hypatia stone, a tiny rock fragment found in a Libyan desert glass field. As reported by phys.org in 2018, the fragment is, quote, "rattling the solar system's status quo, challenging astronomers' fundamental ideas about our solar system's formation and history." In 2015, a number of research teams announced that the material could not be identified based on any known type of meteorite or comet. The phys.org report stated that research by a team at the University of Johannesburg has, quote, "provided unsettling answers that spiral away from conventional views of the material our solar system was formed from. The Hypatia stone consists of strange and never-before-seen combinations of minerals. The dust material found in the fragments confounds the very core of the solar nebular hypothesis." As described by phys.org, "generally, science says that our solar system's planets ultimately formed from a huge, ancient cloud of interstellar dust, the solar nebula in space. The first part of the process would be much like dust bunnies coagulating in an unswept room. Science also holds that the solar nebula was homogeneous, that is, the same kind of dust everywhere, but Hypatia's chemistry tugs at this view. Of course, the Electric Universe theory has always offered a very different story of our solar system's formation and history. Planets and stars do not form through processes of gravitational collapse and accretion in nebular clouds. The discovery of stars forming long networks of filaments, like pearls on a string, is a stunning confirmation of a several decades-old prediction by plasma cosmology. Although today our telescopes can only make out the largest bodies in images of stellar nurseries, the Electric Universe has proposed that planets also form along these filaments through an electromagnetic pinch effect. In fact, essentially nothing space scientists have discovered in recent decades, from the seemingly impossible preponderance of binary stars in our own galaxy, to the endless zoo of, quote, "weird exoplanetary systems," to the ongoing unresolved planetary mysteries in our own solar system, contradicts this view. The Electric Universe theory also proposes that in an era of prehistory, just 7 to 10,000 years ago, our solar system experienced a dramatic reordering. We have said that comets, asteroids, and meteoroids were electrically blasted from planetary surfaces by interplanetary thunderbolts. Science discovery and the study of these bodies only continues to support the electrical interpretation. Like the aforementioned meteorites, comet nuclei tell a tale one would not find from primordial 4.5 billion-year-old bodies. Comets are not the dirty snowballs that astronomers have imagined for well over half a century. All comet nuclei imaged to date have revealed rocky, desiccated surfaces and remarkably complex planetary geology. And like the mysterious meteorite fragments, chemical analysis of comet dust material have revealed a baffling and unexpected history for comets. In the early 2000s, NASA's Stardust spacecraft obtained a dust sample from the comet Vilt 2. The name of the NASA mission was selected because of the perceived nature of the comet itself. Vilt 2 was believed to be a, quote, pristine leftover from the early solar system. And thus, the comet nucleus would offer a rich abundance of primordial ices and ancient dust. The scientists' expectations were outlined as follows in a 1999 press release. Why visit an obscure, hard-to-see object like Vilt 2 when there are so many more notorious comets to choose from? Number 1. It's fresh. Before its near-miss with Jupiter in 1974, comet Vilt 2 was well-preserved in the frigid outer solar system. With its new orbit, Vilt 2 now comes much closer to the Sun. When a comet passes close enough to the Sun, some of its material is boiled off into interplanetary space. Since Vilt 2 has passed the Sun only a few times, it still has most of its dust and gases. It is pristine. However, when scientists on Earth tested the Vilt 2 dust samples, what they found was so unexpected, they initially thought that the early sample may have been contaminated by the spacecraft. Rather than the expected ancient interstellar grains, the Vilt 2 dust grains were much larger than expected and contained minerals such as anorthite and diopside, which require temperatures of thousands of degrees. NASA curator Michael Zelensky said of the discovery, "That's a big surprise. People thought comets would just be cold stuff that formed out where things are very cold. It was kind of a shock to not just find one, but several of these, which implies they are pretty common in the comet." And of course, the comet's desiccated and rocky surface, riddled with so-called impact craters, completely confounded NASA's expectations. A New Scientist article from January 2008 states of the Vilt 2 nucleus, "Samples of comet Vilt 2 suggest it is made of rocky material, like an asteroid, rather than the fluffy dust expected of a comet." As we've covered exhaustively on this channel, since the Vilt 2 findings, science discovery on the nature, composition, and behaviors of comets and asteroids has only shown them to appear more and more closely linked, which was a foundational prediction of the electric universe. Of course, the notion of recent planetary chaos and interplanetary lightning is a radical theory, of which most remain unaware. But inquirers who have closely followed the lines of evidence understand the theory's plausibility. The dramatic craters and other geological features we see on planets and moons do not speak to periodic impacts over countless eons of time. We have shown the evidence that these features are the result of intense electrical discharges, as demonstrated through many decades of laboratory experimentation. The materials blasted from planets and moons had to go somewhere. And it's past time for astronomers to consider that today we see them in the form of comets, asteroids, and meteorites in our solar system.